A high school teacher has a raging addiction to hormones, and she's willing to go to any extent to quench her thirst. Will three students be enough to satisfy her? Let's find out. Hi guys, welcome to Kaylee King. In today's video, we'll be recapping the events of a fantasy drama movie from 1985, titled High School Teacher, Maturing. Warning, spoilers ahead, now let's get right into it. The scene opens in a boys' high school in Japan, where a beautiful woman named Eve works as a teacher. She is the only female teacher in the school and she also happens to be really pretty. As a result, the boys of the entire school are crazy for her. Though she avoids them most of the time, the guys sometimes cross the line and pick on her. Even though Eve was very open-minded about relationships, she didn't like her students flirting with her as it made her uncomfortable. Then we get introduced to another teacher in the school named Johan. Johan and Eve are actually dating, so Eve wants Johan to scold the boys that pick on her. But Johan tells her to ignore them as it's only natural that the guys love the only female teacher in their school. She gets frustrated by this and storms out of the place to head home. She reaches home and we see that Eve lives in a small apartment alone. She decides to freshen up by washing her hands and feet, but just then, her phone starts ringing. She picks up the phone and it's the same guy from her school, asking what's her rate for one night. Even though she is used to receiving these types of calls, this saddens her further. On the other hand, we see that Johan has relations with another girl named Ria, who tells Johan that she is missing him badly. He invites her to his home, and cuts the call. Later, we see that Eve is heading toward Johan's apartment as he is the only one who can lift up her mood. She reaches there unannounced, and surprises Johan. The two then purge hormones together as it's the only reason they are together in the first place. After some time, the apartment's bell rings again and it's Ria who too has come to surprise Johan. Johan lets her inside, but she is shocked to find Eve inside the apartment. This breaks Ria's heart as she thought she was the only one who had Johan's attention. She begins complaining, but Johan, being the Sigma he is, doesn't defend himself and openly admits doing the deed with Eve. Heartbroken and insulted, Ria storms out of the place, devastated. Johan is unaffected by this and reveals that he cannot marry anyone as he finds it pointless. Eve has a similar view on marriage, so the two are together only to quench their thirsts with no emotional baggage. Eve then bids farewell to Johan and the scene ends there. After a couple of days, Eve calls her friend Susie and tells her that she has a leave of 2 days from school, so she is coming to see her. The scene then directly cuts to Eve and Susie together and we learn that the two were in school together, so they are friends since then. They were drinking tea when they hear some noise in the bushes outside the house. Turns out, it is Susie's husband Ren, and he is trimming the bushes. Eve's eyes light up seeing Ren and she decides to do something with Ren. At night, the three of them have dinner, after which Susie and Ren leave to make out. Eve can clearly hear their animalistic noises, which turns her on, and her desire to get with Ren gets even stronger. After 2 days, it's time for Eve to leave and Ren offers to drop her at the station. On their way, Ren asks Eve why she isn't married yet. So she reveals that she doesn't need to. She can make out with anyone and everyone she wants. So she doesn't need marriage. She then signals her desire to Ren, and he stops the car at a hotel. There, the two wreak havoc in the hotel room, and the scene ends there. The following day at the high school, Ria meets Johan and says she needs to talk to him. Johan agrees to talk, but says we'll go to my apartment first. Actually, Ria is so madly in love with Johan that she is unable to move on from him. Inside the apartment, Ria says that she can't let him go no matter what, so she is okay with Johan and Eve sometimes doing the deed. Johan's plan works after all, and now he has two chicks. He begins making his move on Ria and the scene cuts to Eve at her home. She was reading letters when she suddenly feels the urge to vomit. She vomits in the sink and apparently, she has gotten sick due to her trip to Susie's house. Eve then lays on the bed in pain and she takes a medical leave of 3 days from her school. After these 3 days, Eve's hormones are at their peak and she goes to see Johan. Her purpose for coming there is obvious, but she finds Ria there. To Eve's surprise, Johan reveals that they can't be together anymore as he has realized that Ria loves him very dearly. And the two are going to marry in a couple of days. Eve gets disappointed and begins heading home. There, she finds three of her students waiting for her, who have apparently come to check on their ill teacher. She invites all three of them inside for some tea, but they are really shy. To make them comfortable, Eve begins smoking and shares cigarettes with the boys. Eve then serves them dinner and all of them enjoy their time. After that, Eve tells them to go home as it is getting late. but the boys have some other plan in mind and they don't leave. Eve realizes their true intentions and looks at the knife in front of her. Yet, she decides not to use it on her students. Apparently, the shyness on the boys' faces was just nervousness and they soon show their true colors. They assault her one by one and Eve is devastated by their actions. However, after that, post-nut clarity hits them hard and all three of them begin crying for what they have done. They begin apologizing to their teacher, and Eve tells them to leave. She also tells them to keep today's event a secret from everyone else in school. Once the guys leave, Eve cleans herself from the mess and was going about her day, when Ren arrives at her door. Ren's intentions are clear as he cannot forget the time he spent in the hotel with Eve. Eve lets him inside and the two play hormones the entire night. The following day, they go out to have some fun. Ren is actually really rich and he spends a lot of money on Eve. Eve was also enjoying her time, but suddenly, she notices Susie standing in front of them. Eve meets her friend like everything is normal and takes her home, where the three of them have lunch. There, Susie reveals that she knows Rem was here from yesterday. She can't tolerate this behavior from her husband and she'll soon take a divorce from him. As Susie begins leaving, Ren tries to stop and convince her that he is only friends with Eve. Trying to save their relationship, Eve also lies and says they didn't do anything wrong and they only spent some time shopping together. Since she was friends with Susie since school, she didn't want to ruin her married life. Susie calms down upon hearing all this and forgives Ren. After some time, we see Eve teaching in school like normal and she has no relationships with anyone. But what's surprising here is that she uses the same three boys who assaulted her to satisfy her thirst. She has no plans of marrying and settling down anytime soon and wants to use the boys for as long as she can. With her undying lust, the movie ends. That was it for the recap, guys. Let us know in the comments if you like it, and which movie you'll like to see next. Thanks for watching Kaylee King, and we'll see you guys in the next video.